Everybody, how y'all doing? Welcome, 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 everyone. How y'all doing today? I hope you're doing well. So, I wanted to come to you guys today with an interview with someone who knows Tanisha Dule, aka Malia, personally. And if you're in here, go on ahead and hit the link so we could go ahead and get started. Let me check my text messages, y'all. Let me check my text messages real quick. Hold on. Let me just real quick. So we could get into this. Uno momento, guys. All right, I'm going to give him a few minutes because he's at work. And I did text him. I don't know. He's at work, but we'll see. Let's spend a little time. I don't want to really say too much about his identity. I'd like him to introduce himself. But while we wait on our guest, our special guest, to arrive... Hey, vlog lurker. Hey, Taylor. Hey, lady. Let's see. Wait a minute. No. How do I undo that? Can somebody help me? Can I undo that? Snapped on this one. Unhide person. Okay. on high. Oh my God, I wasn't trying to hide you, Liz. Okay, there we go. I unhid you. Oh my God. Liz, please say something in the chat. Yo, I'm blind. I'm blind as a bat. I was trying to do something else. Liz, please say something else in the chat. Please. Liz, if you're here, please say something in the chat. Hey, Empress. Is he her BBF? What? Yes, that was an accident, Liz. Please let me know. Oh, you fixed it? Thank you, Vlog Lurker. Jeez. There you are, Liz. Now, let me do a screenshot of what I'm trying to do. Hold on. All right, there we go. All right. Whew, there you are, Liz. Oh, my God, Liz. Oh, whoo, whoo. Oh. I'm so thankful. Thank you so much, Vlogler. Y'all know I can't see. Stop. Y'all know I can't see. So I'm waiting on the special guest. And I know he at work. I know he at work, but we literally just got off the phone, y'all. Literally. Just got off the phone. So let me give him another call. Because, I mean, in all honesty, if he's caught cold feet, I do have a pre-record version that I'm willing to play. You know, that's what we do as content creators and interviewers. We, you know, will record. But as you can see, his picture's up there. His name, I believe, is, if I'm not mistaken, is Ralph. His name is Ralph. Hey, there you go. Oh, my God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, Lord. Thank you. I'm so happy I did the right thing. Okay, Taylor. Yes. Gang, gang. Hey, well, welcome, unknown. Welcome. So, all right. I don't know what's going on with Ralph. I don't know. Maybe he got cold feet, but we just had a very in-depth conversation. And, you know, Ralph, just so you know, I am going to be playing our conversation. Like, I got to.
It's not a... Okay. I just never addressed nothing like this on... You know, in the public like that, you know.
Right. He said he never did nothing like this on in public. Ralph, come up here. If you got cold feet, it's going to be all good. The people would love to hear from you directly. Hey, yo, son. Hey, man, what's up? Everybody's here. This is a good time for me to go live, I guess. Or maybe it's the interview. The interview. I mean, he may have gotten cold feet, but like I said, I do have this pre-record that I'm going to give him a few more minutes to join y'all, because I would really like y'all to hear directly from him. I don't want to play the recorded version. I want to do it live. That's what we talked about. You know, I had a multitude of questions for him. Which we went over and he was comfortable with for the most part, you know. So I don't know. Maybe something happened. Maybe he got cold feet. Ralph, if you're in the room, please put an emoji in the chat. The link is pinned. Hit that link and come on up. By the way, y'all, when I was playing that audio of him, did y'all hear it okay? Was the volume on it all right? Because that's my other phone and I don't like the volume on that on this phone. Listen, let me know what your thoughts are on the volume. Oh, hold on. He calling me. Hey.
Hey, I'm sorry I missed your call. I was going to get my phone charger.
That's all right. So I'm live right now. Are you going to come in the room and hit the link?
Yeah, did you send me the link on Instagram?
No, just come into the live stream. Once you get into the live stream, you'll see the link. It's pinned right at the top. It's pinned at the top of the chat.
Dang, 71 people here.
Yeah, I know. Don't get cold feet. I think it's a friendly environment. You know, my mods are really, really on it. There won't be any issues. Y'all in the chat, y'all better know. Y'all better know these moderators are out here. So keep it cute. Keep it cute.
So they can hear me?
Yeah, I'm on speaker. Let me take you off. Let me take you off. They can't hear you now. So you're going to hit the link? It's in a white box at the top. It says guest link. Hold on. Are you in the, can you hear my voice? Okay. So if you see, I was going to say, come on now. I'm the one with eye problems. Okay, Ralph. I'm the only one around here when I'm just messing. I have centric nerve damage in my eyes, so I'm always picking about it. There you go. All right, let me let you up. I'm going to hang up here so it will continue the conversation live. All right, hang on. Let me pull him up. All right, guys, so hold on. Why won't this pull him up? Serious? What is going on today? Is opposite day? There. Hey. Can you hear me? I can't hear you. Can y'all hear him? Can you guys hear him in the chat? Let me know, guys. Let me know. You might have to drop and come back because I don't hear any volume. And I'm not tripping. I don't think I'm tripping. I don't think I'm tripping. Okay, so y'all cannot hear him. Cool. Ralph, we can't hear you. So go ahead and drop down and hit the link again. Something went wrong. Thank you. He'll be back. He'll be back, guys. Give him a second. But okay, cool. So he's on the way. I don't know. Technical difficulties with a live environment. Comes with the territory. Let's try this again. There you go. I hear sound.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you good. Cool. How you doing? Okay.
I'm fine. How are you?
Pretty good. First, I want to thank you for keeping your word and, you know, coming up to answer a few questions. And first off, I want you to go ahead and just introduce yourself, whatever you're comfortable with sharing, just, you know, as far as who you are, where you're from.
Well, my name is Ralph, obviously. I'm 27, from New Orleans. I met Tanisha I've known Tanisha since I was about, since I was 16 in high school. And we dated since I was 16 till 21. Well, we were friends first for a year when I was 16. Then we dated at 17. We started dating when I was 17, and from 17 to 21 years old. And yeah, that's so, pretty much it.
Okay, so again, thank you for coming and answering a few questions. And I'm going to just jump right into it because I know you're at work and I know you might get a call. So we want to make good use of our time.
No, I told you, if something comes up, I'll jump back into it.
Okay, cool. Now, did you have any idea that she was planning to leave? And were you guys like still in a relationship when she left?
No, actually, I had no clue that she was leaving. Well, I found out through her Instagram, but I did not know she was leaving. And no, we wasn't talking when we had already broken up by the time she had left.
Okay, I see. So you said you found out through her Instagram. How did you find out through her Instagram? Because she changed her name to By Nature?
No, before that, I think she was doing, she was reposting like his stuff. And I saw she was auditioning for it. Like I think they had like auditions for it.
I see. Yeah, that's a part of the grooming process to get them into the cult. They have to start following long before they arrive. So you said something about her having consequences at home with her sisters and her family. Like, what do you mean about that? Just as far as what you're comfortable with sharing, what do you mean as far as consequences?
Well, you know, I don't think, you know, her, like, it would be like nothing violent or nothing like that, but it's the fact that she left her son for so long and her family for so long, and she'll have to go back to that. And I saw in the video, she even spoke on it. Like, you know, she said it would be awkward for her and uneasy and stuff like that. And, you know, but that would only be because she left, you know. So that would be the consequences of her actions, because she chose to leave. So what she gets when she comes back, you know, she probably won't like it. Not saying it would be worse, because I'm sure it would be better than what's out there. But it'll still be some sort of consequence, you know. Right. And I don't think she wants to face that.
She's probably not ready right now, to be honest. Probably not ready.
I don't think, you know.
But, go ahead.
Well, I was going to say, I don't think she will ever be ready, because that's kind of her, you know, her thing. It's like if she tries to find a way out, you know. I don't think it would be her thing, because the relationship she's had, that she's personally told me, with her sisters hasn't always been the best, and she doesn't feel comfortable even talking to them about, you know, anything that weighs heavy on her heart or her mind, you know. Like, she just doesn't feel comfortable. So she doesn't have any, like, no one. She's never really had anyone to confide in.
Well, you know, it's been, let me ask you this question first. Do you really think that her family realizes her current situation, though, as far as her being? I think at this point she has a bit of Stockholm syndrome. I think she has like trauma responses going on. All of the ladies, just based on what they've been through, what we've heard from actual ex-Carbonation members who were actually there, you know, they have suffered a lot of abuse, physical, verbal, emotional, spiritual. Like, they've been through the ringer. So do you think at this juncture, maybe her sisters have matured to the point where they can strategize to get a plan together? Like, knowing what you know, do you think maybe with time and her son be, her son has to be a constant reminder to the entire family that she's gone?
Right. Well, I think, you know, they realize it, you know, they don't have really a choice. You know, it's everywhere, you know, and especially with her going to the hospital, they have to understand the severity of it, you know, because she's almost lost her life, you know. Right. But at the end of the day, you know, I could go out there, her sisters could go out there and do whatever, but she still has to choose to leave. You know, it's her choice at the end of the day, you know, and until she chooses to do so, that is where she's going to stay.
Yeah. Right.
You know, and as much as I'm sure, I know her sisters want her to come home, you know, not, I don't think her, like her sisters aren't bad people. They just haven't had the best relationship. So, mm-hmm. But I know they love her, you know, and I'm sure they want her to come home just as much as we do. Probably even more. I'm sure even more. But
yeah.
They can want it all they want to, just as much as we want to, but she has to want it even more than them. You know?
True.
And the fact now, is, because
you said, of you had said,
Well, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Well, the fact is that because of her relationship with her family and, you know, the things that they've gone through, and by her being a woman, she doesn't feel like she has something to come home to that will, you know, that will make her feel good, you know, for lack of a better sense. You know, she doesn't, you know, and Nature Boy, being the master manipulator that he is, he knows this. So when she got there, that's why he made her feel so good, you know, and that's how he got control over her, you know. And as much as he's put her through, she still holds on to the good feeling that she has there. You know what I'm saying? And so she won't, she knows what's over here in New Orleans, you know. It was, it may not even be the same, but she knew what it was, you know. And just off of that, she won't come home.
Well, one of my moms said that one of her sisters were in another content creator's chat, the T. I know you're familiar with the T. Big ups to the T. Shout out to the T. But she commented that, you know, they would welcome her with open arms. They want her home. So I think maybe time can mend. You know, like you said, it's up to her. But I think if she kind of realizes and knows that this, that her sisters are willing and waiting and open with open arms, maybe it'll help her make her decision.
There may be some truth to that, but you know, at the same time, why did it take why did it have to get to this point? You know?
Yeah. Like,
it shouldn't have gotten this far, you know. And because it did, and now you want to welcome her with open arms, you can't expect her to be so forthcoming, you know.
Right, absolutely. Now you had said that a part of you feels like you failed her in a way. Like, why do you feel that way? Because you guys were young.
Yes, we were, but you know, I was the man in her life at the time, and the only man at the time. You know, she doesn't have a father, she has a brother, but she didn't really see him as much. Really not as much as she saw me, you know, but we were, me and him were about the same age too. He passed away, God bless him. But,
his name was Isaac, wasn't it?
No, Jarvis.
Oh, I thought it was Isaac. Okay, Jarvis.
Yeah, her brother's name was Jarvis. That's, and, you know, just by, but there was no way I could have, you know, really known. You know, I was so young and I don't want to say immature for my age, but immature for the person she wanted. You know, she didn't have a father figure, and that's what she was looking for. And by me at 21 at the time, I just couldn't give it to her, you know, and I didn't know how. And it was so easy for her to be influenced and, you know, be coerced and be, you know, swayed all these different ways. Because she would talk to, you know, older men. You know, Nature Boy, I think you said he was like 37 or something like
that.
He
was about 37, 38.
You know, and whether or not, you know, as far as experience goes and life goes, you know, a 21-year-old doesn't have nothing on a 37-year-old. You know. Right. And so it was really nothing I could do. But, you know, I was still her man, so I feel a sense of responsibility for her. You know?
True. I get that. Now, I want to get a little, I want to touch a little bit on this point. We talked about it already, but like, I'm a little confused. And just for clarity for everyone too, because you said that her son may possibly be your son?
Yes, it may be so. I'm honestly don't know, because the person she claims who the son is for is the person she cheated on me with right before she left. And that's the person who introduced her to Carbonation. He introduced her to Nature Boy. And, but that person didn't sign her birth
certificate. Wait a minute, hold on. The guy that she said is the baby father was following Nature Boy?
Yes. He introduced her to
Okay.
Well, he introduced him to her, you know. Got her on the following and the page and stuff. And so when the child was born, you know, he didn't sign the birth certificate. When she got pregnant, I believe either before she had the baby or when she got pregnant, he went to another state.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, and, have you explored, you know, trying to get like a paternity test done? Or, I mean, I know, to be honest with you, that her claim, first of all, the mother's claiming that it's another man. It's a real tangled web. But do you even know, have you ever even seen the little boy?
No, I haven't. Not since he was like a very, very, very small baby before she left.
Now, you said you I know there's obstacles with that. You have to file in family court and this and that. So it'll be really, really extremely difficult, especially without her assistance. The biological mother. I'm going to look up to see if I could find some resources in your area where you are to see if we can try to find out how you can go about trying to get that done. Just to be certain that that's not your son walking around here, you know, and she's right about the paternity. But we talked a little bit about who she left the baby with and how she left. Can you reiterate that?
All right. Well, first of all, to be honest with you, I don't think that I just don't think I'm ready for that. You know,
okay.
The home he's growing up in, you know, if the case, you know, I am the father, you know, I will do what I have to do as a man. You know, I don't avoid responsibility, but you know, I don't want to fix what's not broken. You know what I mean?
No, I understand that, but I'll just look up the resources. I'm good at researching. And when you're ready, as far as organizing, because you have to be ready as well. This is not, you know, it's going to be a process. You'll have to go through time, potentially money, things of that nature. Just take a look at the resources so that when that time is right to find out, because at some point, you're going to want to know. You're going to want to know. You probably already want to know.
Well, but it's been actually, about 6 years.
Yeah.
If I really wanted to know, you know, I would take action. I would have took action.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I haven't.
I gotcha.
It's been years, you know. And to be honest with you, because of the way our relationship ended, and this is me being totally honest, you know, I just had ill feelings towards it and towards her. You know, and like when she first went out there, just being completely honest, I really didn't feel sorry for her. Like, you know, it was like, you get what you get. You know, this is your karma, you know. But, you know, just seeing how it kept getting progressively worse, you know, I'm just not a bad person. And I could see she's suffering, you know, and
yeah.
I don't think, no, regardless, nobody deserves to go through that.
Now, and so you've been watching her online.
Yeah, I've seen her.
Do you feel like she's the Tanisha that you know, or has she, do you think that there's drastic changes? Tanisha, when you look at the person sitting there acting like her name is Belia.
Well, that's the thing. So physically, yes, you know, physically, yes, you know, she's always will be Tanisha to me, but the person who she is behind the camera and today is the person that Nature Boy she's the person that he created, you know, so she's Malia. You know, that's what she goes by, you know, and yeah. if she wanted to be something different, then she would, you know, she would be.
I understand that definitely. Do you think that she's easily manipulated?
Yes.
Okay.
But she's easily manipulated because she doesn't have, she's never had the right guidance. You know, she never had, her parents wasn't really in her life. You know, she's had her sisters, you know.
Right. Now, if you could say anything to her, what would it be? Like, pretend you're talking to her directly. What would you say to her, Tanisha, aka Malia? What would you say to her?
I honestly don't know. Because see, this is the thing. I know I've seen a lot of people, you know, especially on social media, call her stupid and ignorant and stuff like that. But that girl is very smart, you know, and, you know, I've known her. So I know she's very, very smart. And she may not make the best decisions, but she knows, you know. So whatever I do tell her, it's not nothing that she either hasn't heard before or doesn't know already, you know. But, you know, I don't. Besides the obvious is that you need to go home, you know. And whatever you're afraid to go home to isn't as bad as what you're going through now, you know.
Yeah.
And you never almost lost your life at home. You almost lost your life out there, you know. But
does anybody in the chat have any questions for Ralph? Like, please be respectful, but any questions? Because those are all my questions, unless you had anything else to add.
Well, I see people saying, you know, that both of the parents don't want the child. But you can't say that because we don't know if I'm the parent. And apparently she didn't want me to be the parent because she claimed that said person was the parent, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and
oh, Libby Lou asked, where did you guys meet? And they met and go ahead. Where did you guys meet?
We met in high school.
Yeah.
Yes, I know he's in prison. No, I haven't spoken to her since she's been there.
She's not made any attempt to reach out to you?
No, not at all. Because like I said in the comment I left, she has a way of trying to avoid consequence. So if she was to ever reach out to me, you know, not saying I would give her consequence, you know, but it would still be some sort of consequence, you know, because of our history, you know, and she was to come back and face me, talk to me, you know. It will make her either feel uneasy or whatever may come with it, you know, because I don't know, you know. I wouldn't try to make her feel uncomfortable or nothing like that. But for every action, there's a reaction. For every cause, there's an effect. And, you know, like I said, you know, nobody on this planet is special enough to have a – no one's special enough to avoid consequences. Everybody has to go through it. And the more you try to avoid it, the worse it gets, which is why she's out there going through what she's going through.
Right. I definitely agree with that. What did you think about them cutting their hair off the in solidarity, because Eligio Bishop had to have his head shaved on upon arrival to prison? Ralph? Can y'all hear him or is it me? Ralph? Ah, he dropped. Well, would you still date her? I'll ask him if he comes back. But those were all my questions for him. I wanted to keep it real simple and short. I actually encountered him in the comment section and reach out to him for a conversation, which he was very open and honest, very forthcoming. To be honest with y'all, like I said, I will send him the resources when he's ready and able to find that answer. And like I said, it's going to be extremely difficult for him to do so with, first of all, Tanisha is in a cult. She's not even around. His guardians that currently have him probably ain't going to want no parts. They have been raising that boy like he's their child. So they're probably not going to want no parts. He's going to have to fight and carry on. So I understand what you guys are saying in the comments, but things get complicated in life. Situations get hard to manage and deal with. You know, so I would say just have some type of understanding as to where he is right now in his journey, in his life. And, you know, I'll send him the resources. I will send him the resources. Hey, Miss Shevin. Is it Shevin? Shevin. Did they have domestic issues as a couple with a pattern that she... No. Mm-mm. They didn't. They did not. He was her... They met when he was 16 years old and they were friends. And then they started dating at 17 all the way up to like 21, 22. Tanisha, aka Malia, left him. I mean, they had stopped talking because she cheated on him with another gentleman. But she did indeed leave the state of New Orleans, left her son, left her family, left him, other friends. And, you know, I want everybody to understand, I'm sure that her family wants her to be okay, wants her to come home. You know, I wonder what type of person she was before the cult. From all accounts, Ralph, you know, said she's very intelligent, very kind, doesn't like confrontation. He had nothing but positive things to say, and he was very honest and open, very candid. Because like I said, we spoke on the back end, and I was going to play that for you guys had he, you know, not hit the link, but he did. So, I don't know if we should, I don't think we need a part two. I think I covered everything. If I think of anything else, I'll see if he's able to hop back in. I know he was also charging his phone. So, his phone may have died. If you have a press, to press a person to get a paternity, that child is better where he's really. Y'all are so mean. Like, come on now. Understand, he's a young man finding his way. And I'm proud of him for coming out and speaking and letting you know, everybody knows. Go deeper on that. Everybody knows that this is a difficult subject. And something very hard to address and approach. Hello? Whoa. Can't hear nothing. Can't hear you. There's no sound. Hello? There's no sound. Hold on 1 second, guys. Un momento, por favor. Hey, what's up? I'm still live. Yeah. So, yeah. He was very open and honest on the back end and very kind and, you know, accommodating to come up here and just speak his truth. So I want y'all to understand that, like, just because he says, you know, maybe the child is better off where they are right now because of his current situation, that's a huge step. Number one, for him to even realize and acknowledge that that may not be something that he can do right now. What y'all want him to do? Go beat down the doors, get paternity, get the child and not be able to feed them, clothe them, get them to school on time, do all the activities that the family's probably already got him in, handle the emotional stress of knowing that his mother's not there. Like, he knows he's not equipped for that yet. And that's cool. That's why I just offer the resources. So just, you know, understand we have to meet people where they're at most times. And eventually, like I said, he will want to know one day. It'll be a nagging question in the back of his mind that he'll want to find out. So just let's see. They will have to understand, give her time. Yeah. Could at least get to. Y'all want him to go to Maury? Yeah, he's not ready. And that's that. He's not ready. He's not ready. And no, just like with Tanisha, aka Malia, we have to allow people to be ready to take steps that they need to take or may take later on. But you know what? It may be a great thing that we had this conversation today. I sent him the resources. And hey, maybe in 10 years, 20 years, he's like, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and he'll probably do the research during that time. Maybe Malia, a.k.a. Tanisha Dulé, will come home during that time. And I'm not talking about reuniting them or nothing. I'm saying they could figure out the parent, the paternity situation much better with her involvement. Much better. But guys, that's all I had today. Thank you guys for showing up. Please be sure to smash the heck out of that like button on your way out. I appreciate each and every one of you moderators. Thank you so much for keeping the environment, you know, clean and cool. I saw my homie Max in the chat. What up, Max? People gonna be mad at me for shouting out Max, but I shouted him out. BB London, Vlog Lurker, Perfect Nails, Liz. Let me see. Lisa says, what in the building? What? Women and children? Eights, baby. Hey, how you doing? Libby Lou, as always, a pleasure to see you. Empress Wah. Hey, Empress. How are you, dear? Thank you for stepping out of the bushes and, you know, hopping in the chat. Let's see. Who else we got in here? I'm going down the list. I sure am, because I didn't have a chance to look at the chat, really. I hope y'all didn't scare my guests off. Clown Around Town, hey, how are you? Kaya and Kayla's mom. Hey, girl, hey. Thank you for being here. Thank you for, you know, supporting the stream. Let's see, who else? Lola. Hey, Lola Baby TV. What's up, girl? How you doing? Thank you for stopping in. Thank you for being here and joining in the conversation. Y'all, I'm still scrolling up. If I missed you, it's not intentional. I'm probably not at your name yet. Hey, Miss Chevron. I said hi to you. Coffee, wine, and water. Hey, Midwife K in the building. Women and children. Let's see. Libby Lou. Who's this? Zion's Joy. Oh, I love your name. Oh my God, Zion's Joy. Samantha, hey girl, hey. Mink, of course. I always love it when you're in the building, Mink. Thank you for coming. Thank you guys so much for supporting the stream and joining in on the conversation. Hey, Bush Babies, if you're not already subscribed to the channel, I don't know what you're waiting for. Go on ahead and subscribe today. Set your notifications to all so that you are notified when I go live or add new content. Hey, Obakan Jones. I hope I said that right. Obakan Jones. I hope I said that right. If I didn't, please forgive me. Or put how you would pronounce that in the chat. I'll do it over. Hey, LP Lurkin, what's up? What's up? Somebody got timed out in the early part of the live. Y'all just come in here starting. Y'all just come in here starting, messing up, carrying on. Come on now. This is not the place to, this is not a playground. Well, I ain't even got to say nothing because my mods be taking care of y'all. They be cleaning. My mods are the street sweepers. My moderators are the YouTube street sweepers. For real, for real. Hey, Lydia. How are you, my 6+5? Nice to see you in the chat, joining the conversation. I appreciate you for supporting the stream. Thank you so much. Let's see. Who else? I think I got everybody. Look, if I forgot you, I didn't mean to. Let me go all the way back down. Oh, before I go, guys, don't forget to enter the raffle. Entries are only $5 per ticket. We are doing... Hey, honey, how are you? Do y'all think his son be safe with her? With Malia? Not right now. Not right now. Not if she did come home, she would need to get some, you know, some mental health treatment and stuff, some love and tender care so she could clear her mind. And, you know, definitely reunification should be considered. That is her son, you know, and no matter what, you always want your parents. But like I was saying, the raffle, guys, enter the raffle today. Entries are only $5. We're doing a 50-50 raffle. You're going to want in on this, guys. The drawing will happen on April 19th. I still haven't decided what time, but I'll keep you guys posted. All right, guys. Until next time, thank you again. And have a great morning, afternoon, or night for wherever you're tuning in from. Later.